Hey everybody, welcome back to the Wolf Pit. Today, I'm going to be grilling ostrich burgers. That's right, ostrich burgers. I know what you're saying. Who eats ostrich? Well, more people than you think. About 20 years ago, I tried my first ostrich burger at a Fuddruckers of all places. Yeah, Fuddruckers. When I ordered it, I remember being asked how I'd like it cooked. And I was dumbfounded and said, doesn't poultry have to be cooked through? Well, to my surprise, they recommended I order it cooked no more than medium rare. So that's what I did, and it turned out to be a fantastic burger. But over the years, I haven't seen ostrich on the menu since, so I've never had a chance to try it again. So today, I'm partnering up with Lance and Todd Applebaum, whose inspiration of ostrich meat fueled the creation of Fossil Farms, where you can find a variety of all-natural sustainable meats and game. Ironically, they're the exclusive ostrich burger suppliers to Fuddruckers in California and New Jersey. So if you're in California or New Jersey, stop into a Fuddruckers and have a Fossil Farms ostrich burger. Or you can simply order it online and enjoy an ostrich burger wherever you live. Fossil Farm ostrich meat is antibiotic, hormone, and steroid-free. It's the healthiest red meat alternative. It's 99% fat-free and is healthier than boneless, skinless chicken breast and is recommended by the American Heart Association. And as you can see, it very much looks like beef. Now back to that 99% fat-free part. You guys know I'm a firm believer, and I say it all the time, that fat equals flavor. So when I see 99% fat-free, I automatically become concerned and think about how awful lean beef is. Lean ground beef usually is gritty, dry, and looks like worms. And of course, it has no flavor. So let's get this 3-pack of 7-ounce, 99% fat-free ostrich burgers unwrapped, seasoned up, and grilled, and see if it's as good as I remember it being at Fuddruckers 20 plus years ago. Look at how beautiful this vibrant red ostrich meat is. It looks like prime beef. This wasn't intentional, but the way I have these patties arranged makes it look like our favorite cartoon mouse. Now I'm going to kiss these ostrich burgers, which if you don't know, kiss simply means keep it simple, stupid. So I'm only going to season these with kosher salt. That way it'll enhance the natural flavors of the ostrich rather than overpowering the flavor. After salting the first side, give them a flip and repeat. One thing I did notice about these raw ostrich burgers is they're firm like beef. I thought they would be loose and very wet like chicken or turkey burgers. Now I have my Gorilla Grill Silverback Pellet Grill preheated to 450 degrees and some well-oiled grill grates. But you can also use a gas grill, a charcoal grill, or cook these on your stovetop in a skillet. Any way you like to cook your burgers will work. Once all your burgers are on the grill, close the lid and stand by for 1.5 minutes. And when I say stand by, I mean stand by. These aren't the type of burgers you want to walk away and check the score of the game or get into an intense political conversation while they cook, because these overcook in a heartbeat. And we all know lean, well-done meat never turns out good. Just cook these burgers like you would prime beef. After the 1.5 minutes, give them the optional quarter turn for the hash marks for visual purposes only. It doesn't make them taste better, but it does make them look better. They say you eat with your eyes first, so if it looks good, you're off to a good start. Then close the lid and let them go for another 1.5 minutes. After cooking for a total of 3 minutes on the first side, give them a flip. And as you can see, the lovely Mrs. Wolfpit wanted to get involved in this video. I like when she cooks with me. That way, if the food turns out bad, I can blame it on her. See, I told you guys those weren't my French nails. Now I'm cooking these ostrich burgers rare. If you want yours cooked a little bit more, cook them for 4 minutes per side for medium rare. But I wouldn't go much past medium rare, they're just too lean. Now close the lid and let them go for another 3 minutes. There's really no need to do the quarter turn since you're only going to see the top hash marks. And if you add cheese like I'm going to do, you're not going to see them anyway. After 2.5 minutes, add your favorite cheese. And I'm using Colby Jack cheese. And I'm only going to put it on 2 of the ostrich burgers because I want to try one by itself. And then close the lid for the final 30 seconds so the cheese will melt. After cooking for 3 minutes per side, for a total of 6 minutes, our ostrich burgers are ready. And with these burgers being so lean, there was barely any shrinkage. So let's get these ostrich burgers off the grill and build our favorite burger. And the way I like to build my burger is on a butter-toasted potato roll with mayonnaise, lettuce, tomato, and onions. And that's it. That's all you need. But you build your burger however you like. So Mrs. Wolfpit and I wanted to try the burger by itself first. And I know some of you think that's really rare, which it is. But to me, that is a thing of beauty. And it's how you're supposed to cook ostrich. And I was really surprised Mrs. Wolfpit tried it. She normally likes her burgers well done. And I told her, no moss on these. You have to try it the way it is. And to my surprise, she loved it, as did I. Here's how I described the texture and the flavor of the ostrich burger. The texture was firm, but not tough at all. It had a great mouthfeel, like tender beef. It was smooth, if that makes any sense, to you, the people. Maybe buttery would have been a better description. The flavor is like a combination of beef and venison with a very, very subtle and delicious mineral flavor to it. And when I say mineral flavor, some of you might think liver, but it didn't taste like liver at all. I would possibly say the taste and texture is that of veal. I was really happy I only seasoned it with kosher salt, because that really made the flavors of the ostrich pop. Next, we tried the fully loaded ostrich burger, which wasn't really necessary to taste at all, because I already knew it was going to taste good after trying the burger by itself. But the butter-toasted potato roll, mayonnaise, and Colby Jack cheese added a phenomenal richness to it, along with a bite from the onion and the freshness of the lettuce and tomato, turned a simple but amazing plain ostrich burger into an absolutely phenomenal, and I do mean phenomenal, burger. It's incredible something so lean and healthy can taste so good. It goes against all my beliefs. I'm gonna go ahead and say it. This is the best burger I've ever had, hands down. And I've had some pretty good prime and Wagyu burgers, and they were great, but they weren't amazing like this ostrich burger. If you'd like to help support the Wolf Pit, consider being a patron. You can pledge as little as $1 a month, that's only $12, for the whole year. Or you can pledge more. That's up to you. Either way, every little bit's appreciated and helps me produce more high-quality videos more often for you, the people. Thank you all very much for watching. Please don't forget to like this video, share it with your family and friends, and I'll see you soon.